Tyre Nichols' family is suing, and decide what you think about the number, $550 million. Also, a supervisor in the Tyre Nichols associated with the incident retires with benefits. Let's give you the details. The family of Tyre Nichols filed a lawsuit against the police officers who beat Nichols during a traffic stop in Memphis, January 7, 2023. That lawsuit also names the city of Memphis, Memphis Police Department, and Memphis Police Chief Cerelyn Davis. Family is seeking, as we said, $550 million in damages for what happened to this young man. In another related development, the Memphis police supervisor on scene when Tyre Nichols was beaten to death. He died several days later, but to be clear, we all were treated to the disgustingness of that beating and know that that is when he truly was not going to survive. We saw it, we know it. That supervisor on scene has retired with his benefits the day before hearing to fire him, according to documents filed to revoke his law enforcement certification. Lieutenant DeWayne Smith identified Friday in records obtained by media outlets as the officer that official said earlier this month had retired before his termination hearing. Some Memphis City Council members were upset an officer was even allowed to retire before steps could be taken to fire them, including the council's vice chairman, J.B. Smiley Jr., who said it didn't seem fair that the then unidentified officer could keep pension, other benefits. I just don't like the fact that his parents are paying this officer to go on and live. And that's troubling. Well said. Seven other Memphis officers were fired after Nichols died following a traffic stop on January 7th. Five of them are charged with second-degree murder. Smith is not charged in Nichols' death. Just the supervisor of this crew, former. The decertification documents against Lieutenant Smith reveal additional details about his actions that night. Smith heard Nichols say, "I can't breathe," as he was propped up against a squad car, but failed to get him medical care or remove his handcuffs, according to the report, AP reporting on this. Smith also didn't get reports from other officers about using force and told Nichols' family he was driving under the influence, even though there was no information to support a charge. Documents said. Investigators said Smith decided without evidence that Nichols was on drugs or drunk. A video captured him telling Nichols, "You done took something," when he arrived at the scene. Additionally, Smith did not wear his body camera. That violated police department policy. His actions were captured on the body cameras of other officers, his subordinates, according to the documents. U.S. Department of Justice is currently reviewing the Memphis Police Department policies on the use of force, de-escalation strategies, and specialized units in response to Nichols' death. It strikes me, Francesca, and I'll start backwards. The U.S. Department of Justice is currently reviewing use of force. That's a red herring because no force was necessary here. To begin with, what do you mean your use of force? It's ridiculous. But there's so many layers here, and I'll let you unpack them first.
Well, I mean, I just, you start with this supervisor, and the fact that he was able to retire before ever being held accountable is where I think we all need to start when it comes to police brutality and violence, right? You know, if we can agree, no matter what side of the political spectrum you're on, no matter what your, you know, income level, no matter where you live, if you can agree that bad actors should be held accountable, let's start there, right? Because that truly is what is holding up any kind of better behavior from those who are supposed to protect and serve us, is the fact that you can retire with full benefits and pension. That is taxpayers' money, right? And it, again, this is a qualified immunity. These are the steps that President Biden, that Congress, that on a statewide level in Tennessee, and then in Memphis, you have a city council person there saying, gee, I didn't realize that you could do this, and that seems pretty wrong. So let's just start there. It is egregious that he was beaten. It is egregious that he is not going home to his mother every day as he used to. It's egregious that his life was cut short. But let's just focus on how we stop it from happening again. And if they know, the supervisors and other folks and police officers know that they're going to be held accountable, maybe that would stop them. But I don't know, Sharon. The buck stopped with him. And he was there and he oversaw the whole thing. And he gets to walk away. Don't you usually, wouldn't that be, if this were a crime, right? Isn't that the sort of the mob boss? Like, if you're the head honcho, sure, shouldn't you be the first one? Or at least still on the hook for all of this? But no, instead the lackeys get it. They're being, you know, charged.
Yeah, even John Gotti got caught in the end. Okay, and, you know, okay, maybe it's not fair. But maybe it is. We saw him in the perp walks, right? We saw totally. Him, he was dressed impeccably, and all we saw was him in the perp walks. And it seems to me that these commissioners, council members speaking out, it sounds wonderful. And I perhaps have no right to put on them something that I don't know necessarily is there, but we all know, at least they do, what the process is going in. So it's nice to make these speeches afterwards and say things like, well, this upsets me. Tyre Nichols' parents are paying for this officer in retirement. Mm-hmm. What is taking so long? Change the process, because I assure you, if it were Sharon Reed or Francesca Fiorentini accused in something like this, baby, in a split second, okay, I hope you got a savings account because your lights would be out, okay? Really? We wouldn't see that beautiful background behind you. I'll give you the last
My lights
word.
Would be out. My
Maybe little... you're off. Yeah, yeah, you got a battery? Got a battery, yeah.
Yeah, no, we're in a week where Fox News just settled for $787 million. And, you know, nobody died. Yes, there were consequences, obviously, for spinning, rumors and falsities about Dominion voting machines. But $550 million, yeah, definitely. Absolutely. For the loss of your child who did nothing wrong but was driving home while black, to be brutally assaulted, not in any kind of what could be even a shred of interpretation as officers being under attack, fearing for their lives. No weapons were found. This was an innocent person who was killed, but in the process, brutalized, terrorized, and of course his entire family. $550 million. Let's start there. I know it sounds like a lot, but let's start there. And the second thing, last thing I'm gonna say is, the taxpayers are also paying for that. You know, taxpayers are also paying for all of these settlements. So I ask everyone, what do we want our money to go to? What? How much are these police actually more of a liability on our taxes? You know, taxes just happened. How much are they a liability, and how much are they actually keeping us safe?
Yeah, for all these people out there who consider themselves conservatives and want to talk about the money and preserving money and a waste of tax dollars, there's your breadcrumbs. We'll
Absolutely.
Start there. This is going to be an incredible show because we're in lockstep. I wrote down a few moments ago, minutes ago, $787 million and the word Fox. If they can pay that out for lying and taking a hit over and over again to really an axe to democracy. Mm-hmm. I have to put democracy in quotes, but that's a whole nother show. Then for killing in the most vicious pond scum ways, this young man, $550, this is way too little, okay? Mm-hmm.